Hi guys, welcome to BAMS Baba. Don't forget Agnimantha, botanical name Primna integri, family Verbenaceae. It is classified under Shothahara, Shita Prashamana, Anuvasa Nopaga, under Charaka, Brihat Panchamoola, Vata Shamana, Viratarvadi, Varunadi in Sushruta. Sanskrit names or synonyms: Agnimantha, Jaya, Shriparna, Ganikarika, Asavarika, Vatagni. Morphology: it's a tree, it grows up to a height of 8 to 10 meters. The bark is smoke colored, leaves are opposite, ovate. Flowers are white, aromatic, and in clusters. Fruits are small like coriander fruit. There are two varieties. One is large variety known as Agnimantha and a small variety known as Tarkari. It is grown throughout India. The properties. The guna is Ruksha and Lagu. Rasa is Tikta Katu Kashaya Madura. Vipaka is Katu Vipaka. Virya is Ushna Virya. Karma: it is a Kafavata Nashaka. Hence it is used in Kafavata disorders. The external uses of it are: the Ushna property helps in cleaning or clearing obstructions of the channels and act as anti-inflammatory and analgesic. The paste of the leaves is used for sprains. Internal uses: it is a best anti-inflammatory drug used in neuralgia and act as analgesic, chiefly used in vata disorders. It's an appetizer, digestive and laxative properties. In the case of respiratory system, it is a kaphagna and acts on diseases caused by obstruction of respiratory system by vitiated kapha. The part used is leaves and root bark. Dosage is 0.5 to 1 gram in churna. The swarasa dose is 15 to 25 ml and kwatha 60 to 100 ml. The formulations or yogas: Agnimantha Kashaya and Dashamoola Arishta. The reference is given in Bhava Prakasha Dhanvantari Nigantu and Kaya Deva Nigantu. Thank you for watching.